You know what, if you want to come, if you want to come against Senra, try. Like, just try. Okay, can I also take something back, like... Iron Swords, actually. Wielding Swords with Wyverns is, like, very weird to me, because my first Fire Emblem game was Awakening, so I just have it drilled in my skull that Wyverns use Axes, and sometimes Wyverns use Lances. So Wyverns using Swords, very weird to me. Very, very weird. Also, yeah, like, genuinely, like, them using Axes. It's just, like... For me, they are the classic unit that uses Axes, you know? That and Heroes. I can... Okay. Sarah continues leveling up very, very well. And, yeah, you are not going to use to hit with an Eclipse against a fast, lucky unit with weapon advantage. No way. And you go for Florina. Respectable choice. Okay. Let's go. This is... This is the guy... I've seen him... Where was it? I've seen him in a chapter. I feel, and I thought he would be relevant. This is from... He was in the chapter where... Actually, where is that guy? The guy who sealed Magic. And Kishuna. He was in the chapter where Kishuna first appeared. The one with the... With the... You know, the Marcus Arafen copycat. So noisy. I thought I could escape battle here on the Dread Eye. No. I'm not interested in why you're fighting. I'm only looking for tranquility. Helping you will bring it to me, then I will lend you my power. Not that I will be that much help. What? Level 16 with a 45, which is pretty damn nice. A ranking both. Very buff magic? In Renault, a cleric wandering Balon, shrouded in mystery. Yeah, you can say that again. Shrouded in mystery, like, who the fuck are you? Only 12 magic. That's weird. But I kind of liked it. I kind of like it. I kind of love you as a unit right now. I really like you, actually. I don't know why, but I like these weird units that come at the end and have like one stat that is inexplicably low. Like, this is great. Okay, so I guess I should have brought the healer up here. Because I got a healer. Good to know. Good to know. Okay, this very, very late recruitment. Interesting. So maybe I have more chapters left than I thought. Or maybe this is like the god of this game, you know? But he's a bit weak for a god. This whole... I do want her to get like a C rank. Or that sweet killer bow. Okay, can I rush here? Yeah. And of course I knew I could. I was just thinking, is there a danger? Like, is there an archer there or something? Well, there's actually archers. Ah, but I don't have to fear them because I have the Delphi shield on her. So no worries. Yes to no weapon level increase. Only deer, right? Yeah, only deer. Okay, so there was an archer. and he can use this, but I don't have to worry. So who was hurt? Is there someone that was like really hurt? Was it Serra? Maybe. No, kill Serra. Kill your reluctant waifu and reluctant. I don't know how it's said, but you probably know what I mean. Yeah, okay. Eclipse is probably going to go for same. He may even hit, but Eclipse cannot kill, so... Yeah, he went for it. He can't hit. I think, like, Eclipse got a buff in hit in this game, but it's still unusable. Okay, you got closer, now I'm going to take your life. I can do it with an errand. I can even do it without animations, because you were standing on a ballista. Everyone knows that there are no ballista animations. Okay, kind of was expecting that, actually. That was a joke because you probably know if you have played enough, but F6 actually has ballista animations, so for some reason they took them away in this game, and most people were like, why do you not have ballista animations when they were already done, like for the same platform, because F6 and F7 were released with like almost no time in between, I think like 2 years, which is fairly low for a Fire Emblem game to you really want to use top 45, but would be a waste. Silver probably one-shots you, yeah? Trina one-shots units, like, one of the, like, most entertaining Pegasus I've ever used. Because most Pegasus, or Pegasi, I think Pegasi is the plural, well, probably people call them Pegasuses, or something like that. Most of them aren't that entertaining to use. When you reach a certain point, they are like really entertaining on the early game, but then you kind of get bored of them because they are like a one-trick pony. They can take care of a certain type of unit, but they also like can take advantage of terrain. Equip the Killing Edge, and I will equip my Iron Sword. Where is Merlinus? Poor Merlinus. He has been left behind. One thing I miss about Merlinus being at the end is that the game had a lot of reinforcements coming from the back, which I actually really like reinforcements from the back when the map is not route. Because it kind of forces you to you know, be a bit wary of like your timing and all. Strength, speed and defense again. Got the clips, so I don't think I'm ever going to use. The clips is only useful when breaking... Oh! Clips is useful when breaking walls. Which is a fairly well-known trick, like... In GBA you have 100 HP walls, so yeah, I did know he was up there, but Okay. No one. Hmm? What's this? Seth's litany. Oh no! Well, actually, I'm going to go up here just in case Seth's litany is like a really good thing. A dance that increases allies' dodge for a turn. That's critical avoid, right? That sounds terrible. That sounds really bad. Like, not worth wasting any space. But I guess it existing is cool. I really wanted a ring that increased your damage. Because I feel like, well, I guess Nini's Grace is already like the super ring. So, I almost missed you. Sorry. Yeah, let's use the silks. Let's pay much respect to the... pay much respects. Fuck, I can't talk today. I'm going to actually like... That was bad. That was pretty bad. Also, I didn't... Yeah, no, I did check Lindstella. She only has a Thimble better, so I don't have to fear Voltings. And let's get closer. Levolt, who hasn't done anything in this map at all. Well, neither has Erk, I think. Er kind of blocked away, but no one came, so in the end he did nothing. Please can't... Okay, that's better. That's better. Okay, well, he went for bite again. Okay, ask and you shall receive. Yeah. So mayhaps you. Okay, can I? Yeah. I can do this. So I'm just outside. Okay, I'm just outside the range. Killer Land sounds pretty nice. Rough. Okay, I can probably kill all of you. Even with the Lance. Which probably benefits me in like the defensive way. Because even if the Reaper does more damage, I take more damage because I'm in open triangle disadvantage. Okay, I'm going to try and give the general to Ganesh. I can perfectly do that. Even in one hit. Boom, and boom. 66 damage to your face. I do miss seeing the damage you do. Like in the modern games, you know. Like when in early game you get like a critical or some combination and you're like, oh, I'm already doing 60 damage in a critical. Even if it's not like actually useful. Okay. Yeah, Renald, what was your level? Level 16? It's pretty high level. Probably double actually, yeah. Look at Marcus. Doing work in the last or one of the last maps in the game. I was saying the last map, but obviously this isn't the last map. I don't think Limstella is going to just end the game. and it's Adora. Okay, I have to use the Silver Sword. But that was perfectly planned out, if I do say so myself. The only thing that worries me now is Baida. This was a Seasgate, right? Yeah, Seasgate. So Elibut has to go there, but Elibut is pretty close. Can you? Yeah. You can. Okay. Problem solved. I see. That kind of unit, huh? I can respect that. Splant. Let's recover uses for the spear. And let's go up. And leave this to the gold. It's the kill. Oh. The gold looking cool. I really don't. Okay, strength. I really don't feel like assassins are overpowered at all. I feel like giving them a promotion on FE6 wouldn't have been the. Like an imbalance thing. If they ever remake FE6, I don't want them to change like a lot of things to like balance units that shouldn't. Like I don't have any problem with Dorothy being a completely horrible unit or Walt being like very bad. Just or even Sophia being basically unusable. That's an amazing level too. Okay, I see. What's... Yeah, she's about to... Fuck. A one-shot with the silver ball? I think I'm just going to enter, yeah. Oh, and she just gains so much experience with every hit. Okay, no strength there, but we're going to get it. We're going to get that. I think it's 23. We're going to get that cap strength Pegasus Knight. Okay. Who wants that one? Probably have... I have weapon advantage against Slim Stella, but I don't think... Well, I have Luna. I will take your life and your essence. But for the sake of my master. That's a cool palette. No critical, but I can do 22 very reliably, so... 17 damage, I didn't notice that was... Like, I thought 17 is very okay, but... he doesn't have the best HP. Silver Sword is my most damage I can do. Marcus probably gets doubled. Marcus doesn't get doubled, Marcus is just a monster. So how much damage do you do? You know what? I'm going to attack. I have a reason for attacking. Because I'm going to... Too bad I use a fortify here. Oh no. This is definitely short material. I don't want to use the silver, but well, now silver is everything I have. Fortify. Now, how much HP did that recover? Okay. Almost, pretty good. Let's get everyone closer. Oh, no movement, no forest. That's not nice. Oh, Sarah actually has good movement on forests. Okay, that's 6 HP. Not a lot. You attack. You're going to take 16 back. Maybe more if I get a lucky critical. Okay. And for Florina. Get kill and return. Yes. One hit. Complete level up. Can you cap strength? Come on, do it. Well, she's actually gaining a lot of resistance in these last levels. Like she had like about 18 resistance or something. Now she has 22. It's pretty amazing. Okay, seem like a global option. Wrath is actually like fairly low level. I think it was like 6, 7. Okay, 16, 9. You are 20 HP. I can do this right now. Okay. So, what do I want to know what to do before? Carol. I think I can reach one cavalier with Sarah for another quick heal. Sarah hasn't reached A in my egg, so she can't use the aura. She actually hasn't attacked in this whole map. But well, it's okay, it's okay. It's not like I needed her to use the aura. Actually, you can use Aura, because you have Fire Rank. So if I really wanted to, I could give it to you. Okay. Yeah. I'm going to do this. Luna and you're gone. That's Slim Stella down. I am not human. This body and this heart are constructs. Yes, as is this sorrow. That's a nice death code. That's actually a really nice death code. This body and this soul are social constructs. And she's. That was a heated battle. I thought it was going to go on forever. It's not finished yet. And there is a waiting at the Dragon's Gate. Look at it. He must pay. For we go to the Dragon's Gate. Nils, if you don't mind, you share your story with us? Huh? I won't force you to if you don't want to. Okay, I'll tell you. I want you to know about me, Anina. I'm millennium ago, Ancient Dragon came from the land, exiled. But no place to go, not in this world. So we used the dragon's skin to flee to another world. We passed through this chasm, in space and time. And of us were lost. Still, we endured the journey. We found humans there too. They were few in number. We had a few skirmishes, but at last, we found home. We were stable there, happy even. Some thought back on our former home, and when we did, his voice reached out to us. Ian was a medium in the other world, and an oracle of sorts. She sat down at the dragon shrine. She had much power. We went prayer at the shrine when it happened. Heard a voice calling to us from the dragon's gate. It was the voice of an old friend. I knew we weren't supposed to open the gate and return to this world. I had no idea that the owner of that voice was Nerga. Nerga. But something unexpected happened. When we opened the dragon's gate and traveled here again, we had lost almost all of our strength. Quintessence left within us was less even than that of an average human. In order to sustain ourselves, in order to breathe the air of this world, we took human form. We placed our energies within that dragon's stone. But our dragon's stone was taken, stolen. And I hope to use it as a tool to summon other dragons. Until we escaped, we couldn't let our foolishness come down our flesh. This guy's as a dancer and a bard, we played and wandered from country to country. That's when I first met Lady Lindis, 1 year ago. That whole time, Nerga was after you? Why didn't you tell me? You were so good to us, we didn't want to cause you any trouble. After we left Lynn at Kalin, we were captured again. We decided that the only way to escape was to cut short all our lives. That was when we met Lord Elber. He was so strong, so kind. He knew what we were, what we had done. He never once condemned us. On the contrary, he tried to set us at ease with stories. Stories of his family, of his homeland. Inian and I listened to his stories. We grew to love his oriental wife and son. Admonition that is too strong a word. We felt his son would be the one to save us. That's what we felt. That's why Lord Elibov. I believe in you. Even though Ninian's gone, I will continue to protect you. I have to. That's Ninian's wish. It's our wish. Let's stop Nerga. You're the only one who can do it. Nils. Let's do it! Elibov! Right, it's too early to give up. I mean, we're still here. We're still alive. Everyone. You're right. My friends are here with me. There's no power in this earth stronger than that. Let's go. The dragon's gate awaits. That's where we'll shatter Nerva's ambitions. Pretty nice. Pretty nice chapter, actually. You see, that's how you make a long chapter without it being Cove of Destiny. You just don't make killing everyone a requirement. Like I felt much better when I knew I didn't have to sweep the entire map. And even if this map was if this map had no reinforcements and was just a roadmap where sometimes when you kill people, the reinforcements come, but you don't get like those Pegasus reinforcements at the end. It would be pretty nice because you don't get Wyvern from the very, very start. Yeah, don't have much to say about this chapter, except I liked it. Rewards weren't like incredible because we're already nearing the end. That guy, Renault. Renault, pretty interesting unit. Fairly sure he's like Carl, you know. I do like those kind of units, the units that come right at the end, like, what the fuck are you doing in this game? And he's just there, he's just vibing. Actually, he's actually very similar to Yoder, the sense that he comes and he's like, okay, so you had a bishop and you didn't train him in light magic. Well, you know, I can easily use the legendary tome if you want to. So he comes here and he says like, oh, you don't have to time to build up Serra's late rank? That's okay, I can use Aura from base. That's a pretty nice. I also really like his stats being so weird, like very high speed and skill, but very low magic. With light already having low damage, he's not that good, to be fair. But he can use a lot of utility stuff, so I feel he can be useful. But yeah. Nice map. Nice map. Nice Limstella map. Not really Limstella centered, like not really like Limstella matters a lot, but Limstella was then like a person of many words at any point of the game, so I wasn't expecting like a very long conversation. And I got a death quote and it was pretty nice. Really like Limstella, one of my favorite characters in this game for some reason. I just really like Limstella, man. I'm glad like you get this chapter instead of Limstella getting like low diffed earlier in the game. It's nice to see Nergal, like, even if Nergal treats the morphs like, you know, like objects and like pieces of shit. It's nice to see like he actually like kind of has a ranking on how useful they are, and Limstella is the most useful out of them all. So Nergal saves Limstella for the very end for you to fight. Is it stupid of him because he could have sent Limstella at the start and killed you? Yes. But it does make a. I mean, it's how it's always worked in Fire Emblem. You get, you know, very powerful people at the end because if not, the game wouldn't make sense. Well. Yeah, and yeah, I like the map, I like the story. Like, not a very complicated map and not a very complicated story. Nil's role in the story at the end, I feel like it's going to matter. He's probably going to be forced in the last chapter. I can already feel that coming. He was forced in this one, he's going to be forced in the last chapter too. Is next chapter going to be the last chapter? I guess we'll have to see. So, leave a like, subscribe, leave a comment, and I will see you in the next part.